Hi everyone, welcome back to Clipping for Coupons with Allie. I am starting two money saving challenges for 2020, and I did not have a piggy bank or a special spot that I like to save money in. So I decided that I was going to turn one of my gift boxes from Christmas into a 2020 savings box. And the reason why I really like this idea is because it has a clear window in the front. I can not only see, but I can also track all of my savings. I really wanted to keep this outside of my bank account, and I also want this to be a family kind of savings plan as well. So this one savings box has multiple purposes. So CVS, a few weeks back, right after Christmas, they had 50% off of all of their gift boxes. There was one that I came across that I really liked for myself, and I did post it on Instagram. So there is an original picture on Instagram. If you're not following me already, make sure you do. You can find me at Clipping for Coupons. And you can see how this box looked originally, so the before and the after picture. But the box was regular price $5, and it came with a loofah, some body scrub, two of them, and a small lotion. And I was kind of disappointed because the two body scrubs that came in this box, they were super, super small, and I was not expecting that. So I was kind of bummed, but now I feel like everything is fine because the products that came in here were not only awesome, but I was able to create this awesome 2020 savings box. So this box was regular $5. It was 50% off. I paid $249, and it was definitely worth it. So go ahead and check out my Instagram page, and you can see the before and the after. But all I did was I cut out a small piece of lined paper up here. I wrote 2020 savings on it, and I already had these stickers at home. I got these stickers during a Dollar Tree haul, so I went ahead and I covered some of the writing. And down here, I did the exact same thing. Again, I like this because you can see through. It almost looks like a shadow box. And the sides are already decorated, so you don't have to worry about that. And then on the back, so I can really keep track and stay on task, I went ahead and I wrote down both of the savings challenges that I'm doing. The first one is a 52-week money savings challenge. Now, everybody does this differently. I am doing what is going to work for me, so I suggest that you guys do the exact same. Our budgets are never going to be the same. Our bills are never going to be the same. The number of people in our households are never going to be the same. So please do what works for you. But this, I think it is going to work for me. Fingers crossed. The 52-week money savings challenge is every single week you pick an amount 1 through 52. I did include zero this time. So if I come across a week where I just have no money in my budget, I'm going to save this zero for then. But other than that, every single week you pick an amount that is listed here, 0 through 52 or 1 through 52, whatever you decide, and you go ahead and you put that amount in. So my check was a little bit short this week because I did miss out on some hours because of the hubby's transplant appointments. So I was only able to put in $4 worth of savings. So what I did was I put in four $1 bills, and then I came to the back of my box and I crossed off the number four. Now this next coming week, I may have a little bit of extra money and I may be able to put $20 or $50, whatever amount I am able to do, I will then go ahead and cross off. And this should give me over $1,000 worth of savings by the end of this year. So the end of 2020, maybe I'll use this for some catching up on some bills, like some credit card bills, or also if you need a car, this is a great way to start some savings for a car fund. Because I don't think that the a little over $1,000 is going to be perfect or ideal, I am also incorporating the penny challenge as well. I didn't want to overwhelm myself with crazy challenges that I knew that I was going to fail at. But you guys, I have tons of pennies at the bottom of my purse. So I thought that this would be perfect and ideal. And both of them seem to fit right in this box, so it should not be a problem at all. The penny challenge is on day one, you save one penny. Day two of the year, you'll save two pennies, and you'll just keep going. So today is January 6th. I owe this box 6 pennies or 6 cents. If you have a quarter instead of the 6 cents, just know you can put it in your box and you'll have even more money at the end of the year. Day 100, you should save $1 and it's just going to go up from there. And the savings should total $667.95 at the end of the year if you are only putting in pennies. So between both of these challenges, I plan on putting some extra into the penny challenge when I can. So I'm hoping between both of these challenges for 2020, I will have about $2,000 saved. So this is just an idea. All I did was take some notebook paper. I cut it to the size of the back of the box and I taped it on here. I'm going to cross off these numbers as I go through weekly. So coming up next week, you will see I'm going to post on Instagram all of my progress. I will go ahead and I will cross off another number on the 52-week challenge. And then the penny challenge, I do that daily instead of weekly. So that should add up pretty quick. Now, here is an example of a bigger one. If you want to have yours and somebody else's combined, or if you want the kids to help and they have their own allowances, you can create an even bigger one. The hubby decided to get the body wash sampler. This is the Cremo, I believe you say it. But there was some body washes that came in here, and this is the same kind of clear window on the front, so you can track and see your progress. Now, for the top on this one, I did tape all the way around so I can't get in it, and I did cut a little hole so I can just slip the dollars and the coins through the top. So I do suggest that you do that, but make sure you're putting tape, especially if you're going to participate in the penny challenge, because this box may get heavy. But you can do the exact same thing with a bigger one. But I just want to remind everyone that coupons do come in these boxes sometimes. So if you want to use a coupon, make sure you clip it while you can. And if you want to clip the coupon while you can, it is going to take the top portion off of the box. However, you can tape a piece of like maybe computer paper or lined paper to fit the top of this, and you can still add in the little slot. So that is my little idea for reusing the gift boxes that you get for holidays. And also, it is my brand new idea for myself, and also a little challenge to see, can I stay on task? Can I actually be disciplined enough to remember and not be lazy enough to put money in here? Who knows, you guys, the year is still brand new. It is only day 6. So make sure you guys stay tuned. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please be sure to like, share, and comment. Subscribe if you haven't already. And don't forget to click that notification button so you do not miss out on a single video.